as I was telling you, today I will be introducing you to the concept called questionnaire, which is a set of questions. Okay? What is a questionnaire?
Collection of questions.
It's good that you didn't tell me my own thing, set of questions. You changed it. Collection of questions.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Yes.
So, yeah. You said that?
Yes.
Okay. He's innovative. Very good. You all have been doing in your own activities, 10 groups are there. Okay. You all are supposed to do the question, am I right?
Yes, sir.
It's mandatory almost. Now you have to be very careful. The quality of your study depends on the questionnaire, which is set of questions or collection of questions. Okay. Is there anyone who is saying, sir, I don't require a questionnaire in my study? Is there anyone?
No, sir.
No one. So you all got convinced, right? Because in the preliminary stages, we got a good talk. The importance of questions, how to get to know. Okay. Now, summarizing all those things, let us talk about a questionnaire. Okay. If you want to prepare a questionnaire, what is the first or few things that strikes your mind? Sorry?
Hypothesis,
research problem, research design, everything got over. Now you are ready to do the survey. You require questionnaires. Okay? So when you start to, you have to design the questionnaire, right? When you design the questionnaire or try to do the questionnaire with your respondents and get the responses, what are the important factors that you have to consider? One is sample size, how many respondents I have to go. Does it make the difference? For example, she has a sample size of 25 and he has a sample size of say 5000. Will the questionnaire change? Sure? This is an interesting discussion actually. Topic is the same. Can you change the topic based on the questionnaire, or size of the questionnaire changes the topic? Which is correct? Topic, your research problem defines the size of the questionnaire, or size of the respondents. That is one. Or the other way, if you have decided to increase the size of the respondent, that is sample size, your research problem changes. Which one is correct? First one or second one? Did you get my question? I repeat again. Research question, research problem, it's clear. Accordingly, you said this is the sample size. That is correct. Or based on the sample size, you will fix the research problem. Obviously, first one. So there is no doubt about it. Okay? So now the other question is, based on the sample size, will your questionnaire vary? Sample size 25, sample size 5000. Will the questionnaire vary? Set of questions, a collection of questions.
No.
Will it differ?
No.
It will not. The rigor, the flavor, the intensity of the questions will not change, irrespective of the
sample size.
If the one student is sitting in the class, full class, that is 60 students are sitting in the class, my delivery is the same. Maybe only one student will be stressed. Any question. If it is 60 students, four people will be there to help each and everyone. Make some process. Right? Tell this girl. In student point of view, there could be a difference. But in faculty point of view, if one student is there, 60 students are there, it doesn't make any difference. Okay? So, are there any clues? What are your factors? So, depending on those, I think that's what I was telling your friend. Research objectives, research problem, research design, including hypothesis, the way you want to analyze, everything is fine. Everything is designed, it is done. Sample size, okay. Let me tell you. So, the questionnaire is related your research problem, right? Research problem or research objectives. Okay? As our friend was saying, hypothesis. Based on this, questionnaire has to be done. There's no doubt about it. In addition to that, is there anything else that you have to consider?
Research type.
Sorry?
Research type.
Research type. What is research type? Explanatory, exploratory, lab or field survey, qualitative, quantitative, okay, one time or recurring, based on long term, one time, test versus diagnostic, if it is a medical research, yeah, perfect. So you have revised types of research, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Gautam? Good. Very good. My students are in track. Now I have to ensure that you are not deviant. You have to hold it strongly. Very good. So, one is type of research. Then, I'm telling you sample size will not influence the questionnaire, the composition or whatever. Anything else like that? Type of research. That, what is that?
Research.
Research design, okay, I take it. Then? Data collection, is that the primary data or secondary data? That's what you are saying. Can you do questionnaire in secondary data, Madhuri? So your primary data, you are doing primary data. Then what is the point here? Okay, how you approach the respondent? Are you saying that? Are you approaching the respondent person in person to person or through email or phone? Yeah, that may make a difference. That may make a difference. Anything else like that? It's good. I got a lot of, maybe the video is giving the impact or influence. Lot of questions, lot of inputs. But Gautam is targeting only me, not the other respondents. Maybe we need to have one more camp. Fine. When you talk about questionnaire, you should be very clear on what is your research problem, why you are doing this, objective to error solutions, right? Within that, what are the specific objectives, general objectives kind of thing, then what is your hypothesis, research design, okay? Research design is also there. Then, when coming to this, first thing is, who is your respondent? That's very, very important. The whole thing is same, okay? But if your respondent is, say, a farmer in a village, homemaker or housewife, homemaker is a better word, students, management students, software engineer who is already working, maybe married also. Okay? Can you give the same question for all these four? This will not change, huh? Please don't misunderstand. This will not change. Can you give the same questionnaire to all these four verticals? No way. Farmers may not understand the technicality of the questions themselves. Okay? If your respondents are diversified like this, it's a big trouble to you. It's challenging. That is the reason in your own survey I am trying to help you. Please define your respondent. Is that the adult, parent or child? Are you child or adult? Don't say child. For your parents, you are still kids. Even your adult or even you become parent, you are fixed to them. That is different. But now we are in the adult stage. You know transactional analysis, you remember?
Yes, sir.
I think Vicky was talking. Child, adult and parent. Okay? Now if you can put them here, I think they are diversified, little diversified. Now the thing is, based on the research problem, if you can filter out any one or three of them, your job is easy. Am I right? As the other day I was talking to Chandu, when you go to the people and ask about preference of youngsters to job over business, that was your research title, right? In that case, can he approach everyone? No way.
Only students.
That's it. No one else. Yes? I'm asking you, what are the health problems in Vijayanagaram? Of the people who are living in Vijayanagaram. Now, can you filter out of these four? You have to cover all. You cannot. Can you filter them? If you are filtering, you are biased. You are biased. We discussed about random sampling and non-random sampling. Even before that, you are fixing the game in your own favor. Okay? So, the first factor is who you are approaching. That is your respondent. Where is he or where is he? Where is she? Who are they? What are they? What are they doing? And you have to connect them to your research problem. You cannot directly go with your research problem and start inquiring them and grilling them like a policeman. They will not be happy. They will not respond to you. Okay? So, because of that reason, you have to understand your respondents. If possible, you have to put different set of questions. But at the end, you will be, for example, if you go to a farmer, you have to ask him in a very polite way. అన్నా నీ పేరేంటా నీ పేరు తెలంగాణ అన్నయ్య నీ పేరేంటి చెప్పని సంథింగ్ లైక్ దట్ యూ టాక్ లైక్ దట్ బట్ ఇఫ్ యూఆర్ అప్రోచింగ్ అ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ ఇంజనీర్ ఇన్ బెంగళూర్ యూ విల్ ఫీల్ బ్యాడ్ ఇఫ్ యూఆర్ టాకింగ్ ఇన్ మదర్ టంగ్ యూ విల్ బి హ్యాపీ ఇఫ్ యూర్ టాకింగ్ ఇన్ ఇంగ్లీష్ హే బ్రో వాట్స్ యువర్ నేమ్ బ్రో ఇఫ్ యూ సే దట్ యూ విల్ బి సో హ్యాపీ రైట్ సో యువర్ క్వశ్చన్ ఇస్ ద సేమ్ యూ ఆర్ టేకింగ్ ద నేమ్ ఆఫ్ ద పర్సన్ క్వశ్చన్ ఇస్ ద సేమ్ బట్ ద వే యూఆర్ ఆస్కింగ్ ఇస్ డిఫరెంట్ The way you are phrasing is different. Did you understand? So in that way, there could be differences in questions. So let us take this as a starting point and discuss more after your given exams. Any question on this? Any question on the questionnaire? I'm on video. Any question? On our discussion. Thank you. See you tomorrow.